गाइस, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर विथ यू हाउ टू मेक दिस शेल विथ क्रोशे। सो टू मेक दिस शेल आई हैव यूज्ड चेन स्टिचेस, सिंगल क्रोशे, हाफ डबल क्रोशे एंड डबल क्रोशे स्टिचेस एंड टोटल 16 राउंड टू गेट दिस साइज। एंड टू मेक दिस आई हैव यूज्ड कॉटन थ्रेड। यू कैन यूज़ दिस शेल इन एनी ऑफ योर crochet home decoration. Apart from this shell, I also made this spiral shell and this conch shell. You can get a video in my previous videos. So let's see what I have used to make this she shell. To make this, I am going to use this cotton thread, and for this thread I'm going to use crochet hook of size 3.0 mm. You will also need one stitch marker, needle and scissor. So let's see how we are going to make this shell. So just leave some extra thread, this much, and make chain 7. So make a slip knot in your hook. Now make chain 7. After chain 7, we are going to skip our first chain and into the remaining 6 stitches. We are going to make one single crochet. So here I am going to make the single crochet at the back side knot. So when you turn your work at the back side, you can see these knots are there. So in this knot I am going to make single crochets. But if you are not comfortable, you can work in these stitches also. Skip first chain and from the second stitch make one single crochet. So total you will have 6 stitches. So 6 single crochets. This is our first row. Now make chain 1, turn your work. So skip this turning chain and into the remaining 6 stitches from the previous round, make one single crochet. Now make chain 1, turn your work. So you can see this stitches has a V shape like this. So this is the front side and this is the back side. So in row number 3 we are going to work in this back loops of this stitch. So skip the turning chain and make one single crochets by taking the back loop of each stitch. So take your hook in the back loop and make one single crochet. So like this, make one single crochets in the remaining stitches. So at the end of row number 3, again we will have 6 single crochet stitch. So row number 3 is done with 6 single crochets. Now make chain 3. This is our turning chains. Now turn your work. In row number 4, we are going to work in both the loops like how normally we work on these stitches. So in first stitch, make 2 double crochet. So after 2 double crochets, into the next 4 stitches, make 1 double crochet. Then into the last stitch, make 2 double crochet. So our row number 4 is done with total 8 double crochet stitches. Again make turning chain 3, then turn your work. So in row number 5, make 2 double crochets in each stitch from the previous row and work on both the loops. So 1 and 1 more in same space. So 2 double crochet like this, work in remaining stitches. So at the end of row number 5, you will have 16 stitches. So row number 5 is done with 16 stitches. Now make chain 3. Turn your work. In row number 6, so make 2 double crochets by taking the back loop of each stitch. So 1. Take your hook in the back loop and make 1 more, so 2. So 2 double crochets like this. Have to make 2 double crochets in each stitch from the previous round by taking the back loop of these stitches. So round number 6 is done with total 32 stitches. Now make chain 3. Turn your work. Now in row number 7, we are going to work on both the loops. So into the next 2 stitches, make 2 double crochet. After 2 double crochet, into the next 28 stitches, make 1 double crochet and work on both the loops of the stitch. So after 28 double crochets, into the last 2 stitches, make 2 double crochets. So one more in same space. Two, and in this last stitch, make 2 double crochet. So row number 7 is done with total 36 stitches. Now make chain 2. Turn your work. Now in row number 8, skip this 2 turning chain and top of very first stitch, make 2 half double crochet. Work on both the loops. Now into the next 2 stitches, make 1 half double crochet. Work on both the loops. So 1, then into the next 2, then into the next stitch, make 2 half double crochet. So after 2 half double crochet, into the next 2 stitch, make 1 half double crochet. Then into the next 1. And into the next, make 2 half double crochet. So like this, repeat these stitches. Into the next 2 stitch, make 1 half double crochet. Then into the next stitch, make 2 half double crochet. Then into the next 1, then next 2. So at the end of row number 8, you will have 48 stitches. Now make chain 2. Make chain 2. Turn your work. In row number 9, we are going to work in back loop of each stitch and make 1 half double crochet. Now grab the yarn, take your hook in the back loop and make 1 half double crochet. Then into the next stitch, work on back loop and make 1 half double crochet. So like this, work on the back loop of each stitch and make 1 half double crochet. So at the end of row number 9, we will have 48 stitches. So round number 9 is done with 48 stitches. Now from this end count 8 stitches, so 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 and 8. So in this 8th stitch we are going to make a slip stitch to join these two ends together. So now take your hook in top of 8th stitch and make a slip stitch. So by that this two ends got joined and we get this part separately. Row number 10, we are going to decrease these stitches. So first make chain 2. Now we are going to decrease the half double crochet stitches. So to make the decrease we are going to work on the front loop. So this is the front loop of these stitches. So in this round we are going to work on this front loop. So to do the decrease, what you have to do, grab this thread. Now take your hook in the front loop of next stitch, grab the thread and pull through that. Grab the thread. Now take your hook in the front loop of next half double crochet, grab the thread and pull through that. Now grab the thread and pull through all the loops in your hook. So this is our first decrease. So like this you have to make the decreases. So grab the thread, take your hook in the front loop, grab the thread and pull through that. So you will have 3 loop. Now grab the thread, take your hook in the front loop, grab the thread and pull through that. So we will have 5 loop. Now grab the thread and pull through all 5 loop in your hook. So second decrease. Just put the stitch marker. So this is my first stitch. I'm going to put the marker here. So 1 2 3. So like this repeat the stitches. So 20 decreases is done. Now we come to the very starting stitch. So this is our chain 2 and this is our last stitch. So top of that stitch make 1 half double crochet. So we have total 20 decreases and 1 half double crochet. So in total 21 stitches. Now in row number 11 make chain 2. This is our turning chain. Then turn your work. Now skip this 2 turning chain and top of very first stitch make 1 half double crochet. So 1, then into the next make 1 half double crochet, 2, then into the next stitch make 2 half double crochet, 3. Now repeat these stitches. Into the next 2 stitch make 1 half double crochet, then into the next stitch make 2 half double crochet till this point. So at the end of row number 11 you will have 28 stitches. This is our very first stitch. So top of that make a slip stitch. So this round is done with 28 stitches. Now in row number 12, make chain 2, then turn your work. Now we are going to work in back loop of these stitches and make 1 half double crochet stitch. Skip this turning chain 2, then into the next stitch work on the back loop and make 1 half double crochet, 1, then into the next stitch work on the back loop and make 1 half double crochet, so 2. Put the marker here. So like this, work on the back loop and make 1 half double crochet. So at the end of row number 12, we will have 28 stitches, 28 half double crochets. Now in first chain 2, top of that make 1 slip stitch. Try to take both the loops and make 1 slip stitch. In row number 13, we are going to make decrease of 1 half double crochet, and here in this row we are going to work again in the front loop of these stitches here. So to make the decrease, again grab this thread, take your hook in the front loop, grab the thread and pull through that, grab the thread, take your hook into the front loop of next stitch, grab the thread and pull through that, grab the thread and pull through all the stitches. So 1 decrease of half double crochet. So like this, you have to repeat this decrease, and at the end of row number 13 we will have 14 stitches. So 14 stitches. Now make 1 slip stitch on top of very first stitch to complete this row number 13. Now in row number 14, we are going to work in the back loop of these stitches and make 1 half double crochet. So grab the thread, take your hook into the back loop of next stitch and work 1 half double crochet, so 1, then into the next stitch to the back loop, make 1 half double crochet. So like this, make 1 half double crochet and complete row number 14 with 14 stitches. So after 14 half double crochets, top of first stitch make a slip stitch. Now in row number 15, again we are going to decrease 1 half double crochet, make 2 half double crochets together and make 1 decrease. So take the front loop, grab the thread, take the front loop of next stitch, grab the thread and pull through that. Now grab the thread and pull through all loop in your hook. So like this, total 7 stitches. So 7 stitches. Now this is our last row. So in row number 16, we are going to make 1 single crochet in top of each stitch. Next stitch, make a slip stitch, pull this thread, cut with some margin, take this thread in a needle. Here we are going to close this gap, so take the front loop of next stitch and this side take the back loop of next stitch, just close this part like this. So this is done. Now take this loose end in a needle, just join these two ends and stitch this part. So this is done. If you want, you can just stitch this part or keep it like this, it's up to you. I'm going to just stitch this part. So this is done. If you want, you can fill this gap with filling. I'm going to keep this like this. If you are making this shell with a plain thread like this, so just in each row just make this embroidery chain stitches, so to give this look. So I hope you have learned from this video how to make this banded tulip shell. If you have any questions or query, please do let me know in comment section. You can also connect to me through my Insta and Facebook page. So see you in my next video. Till then, bye bye, take care.